What was your reason for going to Provincetown in the first place?
Because I went to Fire Island and I absolutely hated it. So I went to Provincetown instead. It was to get away from this relationship I was in New York. And, you know.
What happened?
Wanted to suck dick and be a crazy queen and young and drugs and the whole thing. And, then I went to Provincetown. And I sucked dick and did drugs and was crazy.
Did it hook you on the city? Did it hook you on Provincetown rather?
No, what hooked me, in fact, I can say this, what hooked me on Provincetown is no longer a Provincetown. Ladies and the architecture and the rawness and the hippies and the bohemian lifestyle and the artists and all the things that are now missing because some yuppie wants the Anderson window plugged in the side of his fucking redone 8 condos per square foot fucking. Fuck me. Smoke me on that.
Do you think that's taken away Provincetown's soul?
Hey, you got it, kid. Provincetown once had a soul that was actually a living, breathing being on its own right, with or without people. It was an experience and beauty, and it was closest to God I've ever been anywhere in my life. And now, it's nothing but a fucking strip mall, full of yuppies trying to outdo the other one of this fucking fucked up elitist classist crap.
What do you think about the drug situation here?
What do I think about what drug situation? The drug situation at circuit parties and stuff?
Well, the drugs in general. The fact that people think people are doing too many drugs and problem stuff.
People, you know, are going to always do drugs, no matter what. I mean, you know, there's a reason why they're doing more drugs in Provincetown than ever, because Provincetown's not as fun as it used to be anyway, so people have to do more drugs to make it fun. It's horribly boring. What is there to do besides suck cock and drink and do drugs? You tell me. I mean, go to the beach and stuff like that, but they got so many restrictions, and everything costs $80 to park to fucking go to the beach. And then you've got some yuppie-ass motherfucker who owns half the beach who won't let you be in their vista. You know? I like it better when fags were oppressed, honey. They were so much smarter and more fun and interesting and great. Now they're all trying to be Abercrombie straight boy fuck-face fuckers and fuck.
I was at the gym the other day working out next to an older Portuguese woman.
Yeah.
And I asked her how she felt about it. She said that she really resented the fact that all these people were coming to town to get drunk and whatnot. So I asked her if she drank. Her response to me was, no, except on vacation. How do you think about that with respect to most of the critique coming from people in
town? Well, I mean, I think that people have always gone there to get drunk and always whatever, and I don't have any issues with the drug thing. I mean, for myself, I'm trying to cut back, but I mean, I don't have issues with drug thing for people who go there, but I mean, you know, I mean, if you're a sad person, you're going to OD, because you just want to kill yourself anyway, and if you're not a sad person, you're probably doing it recreationally, and if you get OD by mistake, well, then it's the same thing as stepping out in front of a car in traffic. It's something that happens. It's a mistake, and if you do it on purpose, you want to kill yourself, you know, how else to do it. I don't think Provincetown is that anymore. Do I feel like I get back to that? Yes, with people like you, me, John Dowd, other people, but we're getting older.
Mm, true.
And, you know, Provincetown will not return to the way it used to be. Hi, Slob.
Hello.
Unless some young people like us get involved and turn over the apple cart. And sitting on the apple cart might be me. And if that happens, then I have to take my knock for that, because that's the way life works. You know, I guess, at the end, I love Provincetown more than any other place in on Earth. I'll always consider it my home. I wouldn't be so upset about the destruction of it if I just love it as much as I do. I'm not just ranting because of an ego trip or I feel it's funny or, you know, it's a way for me to get pressed or anything like that. I'm ranting because I'm angry about a place that was so beautiful and so it had to, again, put the soul to it. They've just been destroyed by people who no longer care about what their neighbor thinks. They'll just go to higher ground.
Theater. Provincetown.
Right.
The birthplace of American theater. How do you feel?
It isn't. It isn't the birthplace of America. I mean, Eugene O'Neill was great and everything, but he's not the end-all and be-all American playwright. Tennessee Williams is the end-all be-all American playwright. Although I love Anna Christie. She's a genius Eugene O'Neill play, but the rest of them are just depressing and dull and self-involved. But Tennessee Williams is a genius.
How do you think you're contributing to the, you know, to the continuation of American theater?
I'm just doing my small part to, like, you know, get people to enjoy theater. I don't want theater to die. It's one of my biggest fears, and I think it will, because, you know, people are becoming more and more distant from each other with technology ideas and stuff. But television has sunk to the deepest, lowest low. I mean, I can't imagine people not coming back to theater. I hope for a redo of a renaissance of theater, you know, in a sense of, like, you know, seeing the human experience and, like, immediate compared to fed through so many channels, which is what, you know, television's like fed through the advertisers, fed through the senses of like, you know, I hope that theater returns to that. And theater is a great way to go out, get out of your fucking house and meet people and stuff like that, but I don't know.
Isn't your theater really utilizing those, you know, I understand your lament for the technology and the television order, but you use a great deal of that as necessary references in order to pull through into what you're up to?
Necessary references, exactly. It's a reflection of the only things that they know. I mean, if I start, you know, going into, you know, Noam Chomsky, I don't know how many people are going to know what I'm talking about, you know what I mean?
You sometimes use, again, back to the cultural references, back to the that sort of thing. You know, in, you
are... You know what they're like? They're like starring puppets. They're not, they do nothing to the story. What they do is they put the audience at ease to not feel like they're lost in a Euripides play like Medea that they might find too petty and not... People are scared of theater because there's been so much shitty theater and so much supposed intellectual theater. That they're afraid of it, because they go and they're bored out of their fucking mind. And so, that's not the only way to tell a story, is that sort of like my vocabulary or ideals or you know, intellect is higher than yours, therefore you have to come up to mine. No, that's not the way it should be. Theater should bow to its audience. It shouldn't expect the audience to bow to it, I feel. So, I mean, there are great stories and great historical things and great genres and great avenues to take that are endless in theater. You know, like this year we've done Mad Max, which is a soap opera-ish old 50s thing, and then we did Rosemary's Baby, which was a musical, rock musical, freaky sex thing. Now we're doing Camille, which is a delicate, beautiful springtime love story. And so these stories are infinite. There's so much possibility. And
what do you think you'll do for summertime in Provincetown?
Carry, because I've learned in the summertime in Provincetown, to get an audience, I do need to go back to cultural references. But Carry isn't a television show. I mean, Carry had a huge effect on us as teenagers.